In this lesson, you are going to learn all about placing chamfers in the feature mode. You may remember that it's possible to add chamfers in the sketch mode. It's typically better to add chamfers in the feature mode because you have more control over them. First of all, if I were to go back and edit the original sketch and add chamfers to each of those corners, I could chamfer the four corners in the sketch. However, I would not be able to chamfer, for example, this corner in the 3D solid. Also, when I do chamfers in the 3D mode, I will end up with another feature in my model browser, making it much easier to edit it after the fact. So let's look at the chamfer command. It's located here on the 3D model tab in the modify panel. I'll start the chamfer command. And the first thing it wants me to do is pick an edge. You can see that's selected. So I'll go ahead and pick an edge here in my part. Then I can specify a distance. So let's say I want to go a quarter inch for this one. And if I'm happy with that, I can go ahead and click OK, but we'll look at several of the options here as well. So the first option is to do equal distances. So I'm getting a 0.25 by 0.25 chamfer. Both distances are equal. I could also switch it to distance and angle. So if I knew, for example, that I wanted it to come in, we'll say half an inch, and I wanted the chamfer to be at a 30 degree angle. So the first thing I'm going to select then is the face that the half inch is going to be cut off of, and the angle is going to come off of that face. So I'll click the top of this part here. Then I can select the edge. So as you can see, the half inch came off of this top surface, and the 30 degree angle is from that top surface since I selected that face. Now it's very easy to go back and edit chamfers. I can either double click on them in the model browser or right click and edit feature. Let's try a different mode. Let's say I wanted to use two different distances. I want half an inch in one direction and a quarter inch in the other. Then I can come in and go ahead and pick the edge. As you can see, I've got half inch coming off one and a quarter inch off of the other. If that's not the orientation I wanted, we have a flip button here so that we can flip it the other direction. And then again, I can click OK. Let's take a look at a couple more options here. I'm going to back up and start the chamfer command again. And I'm going to go back to the same distance in each direction. And I'll go with half inch again. On each of my earlier examples, I only picked on one edge, but I can select multiple edges, as you can see here. And you'll notice that by default here, I have this extra cut to make this triangular face. This is called a setback. So here in the chamfer dialog box, I can control whether or not a setback is created. If I click to turn it off, then you can see that basically it's just the three cuts that were used to create the three different chamfers. So again, very easy to switch between those two different options there. Once again, the big benefit of doing the chamfers in a 3D mode is, first of all, I can do them in different directions, not just in the sketch, and it makes them really easy to edit. You already saw me edit a chamfer a couple of times. If I wanted to completely get rid of chamfers, I can just simply delete them from the model browser and they're gone, which is a lot easier than going back and editing sketches and maybe having to reconstrain some geometry. We'll look at another option here of the chamfer command, and that is something that's turned on by default, which is edge chain. Edge chain will automatically pick up tangent edges. You can see that when I come in and pick on this straight edge, it automatically picks up the tangent edges around to the back of the part. If I was just wanting to do the one edge though, I can turn off edge chain. And as you can see, as I select that one edge, it's now just going to chamfer along that one direction. As you can see, it does cut into the circular shape because it needs to continue on. But once more, it does not pick up the tangent edges going around the part. We also have the ability to chamfer just a portion of an edge. I'll begin the chamfer command again and select an edge. Then I will click on the partial tab here. Here I will come in and pick a point somewhere on the chamfered edge, and I'll just pick either a start or end point here. Then I can specify basically two values. One is the length of the chamfer. So if I don't want it to go the full length, how far do I want it to go? Let's say I want it to go 2.5 inches. As you can see, by default, it's just going to go halfway into this part because this part is already set to 5 inches. So I can have it come in just a certain distance rather than the full edge. I can also offset that distance. So from the start here, I can bring it in 1 1/4 inch, and that will now give me a 1 1/4 inch on each side. So I now have this chamfer centered right in the middle of that edge. To recap, when we chamfer, we can use 3 different methods, 2 equal distances, a distance and an angle, and 2 different distances. We have the ability to decide whether or not we want tangent edges selected. We also have the ability to turn setbacks on and off if we have multiple chamfers meeting at a corner. And then we have the ability to do partial chamfers, where we're only doing a portion of an edge. And then finally, we can modify our chamfers very easily by either right-clicking an editing feature or double-clicking on them in the model browser. That concludes this look at placing chamfers in Autodesk Inventor.